Hi friends, welcome back to this channel of Jury and Justice, Shruti Desai's lecture on law. We are meeting after a brief break. I apologize for the same. Before starting with today's RERA, we are learning RERA. So before starting with today's lecture, I request all of you to subscribe for this channel and also click on the bell icon. If you want to know more about me, do visit my website www.shrutidesai.in/. Last occasion we stopped on the definition of completion certificate, and we said that completion certificate means it certifies that the construction is in as per the accordance of the plan. However, a completion certificate is not a final document, or is a final document. We will come to that when we understand and discuss the definition of occupation certificate. Now today we will move further and we will discuss the definition of development. This is very important because in Maharashtra, in Mumbai, in RERA, there are many news items that there is a setback to redevelopment projects, and redevelopment agreements are not subject to RERA. I will read the definition S of development in this act of RERA. It says, with its grammatical variations and cognate expressions, means carrying out of the development of immovable property, engineering or other operations in or over or under the land, or the making of any material change in any immovable property or land, and it includes redevelopment. Now there is after reading this definition, we need not have any further discussion because the definition itself includes redevelopment. So when definition includes redevelopment, RERA has jurisdiction to determine the redevelopment agreements and permanent alternate agreements. Yes, but if there is a dispute of the nature of a tenant and the landlord, whereby there is a dispute, you know, in permanent alternate accommodation agreements, there is a dispute in the nature of tenant and the landlord, or some other inheritance dispute, RERA has no jurisdiction. But as far as possession is concerned, or quality of work is concerned, or the area, carpet area is concerned, RERA certainly has jurisdiction. So any discussion otherwise or in negative is uncalled for, according to my analysis, because it itself provides, RERA Act itself provides inclusive definition of development. Now next is development work. Means it defines, it means the external development works and internal development works on the immovable property. So external and internal is your own flat, and external is the done by the society or the builder, and that includes everything rather. And next is engineer. Engineer is defined to mean a person who possesses a bachelor's degree or equivalent from an institution recognized by All India Council of Technical Education, or any university or any institution recognized under a law, or is registered as an engineer under any law for the time being in force. Next is estimated cost of real estate project. Means the total cost involved in developing the real estate project, and includes the land cost, taxes, cess development and other charges. This is important because Maharashtra has its own circular regarding estimated cost of real estate project. We will discuss tomorrow Today we are discussing only definition. Tomorrow we will discuss more on this this aspect of estimated total cost of real estate project, because we have to discuss that circular. External development work is also defined in the Act. It includes roads, road system, landscaping, water supply, sewage and drainage system, electricity supply, transformer, substation, solid waste management and disposal, or any other work which may have to be executed in the periphery of or outside a project for its benefit, as may be provided under the local laws. This is about the external development works. Okay, now let's go to the next definition, is that of family. It is an inclusive definition, and it says that it includes husband, wife, minor son and unmarried daughter wholly dependent on a person. That is family. Now next is garage. In Mumbai, garage is very important thing. First I will read out the definition and then I will say about garage and the DC rule. It is defined, garage in 2-wife means a place within a project having a roof and walls on three sides. That is a roof and the walls on three sides, this two and the back, for parking any vehicle, but does not include an unenclosed or uncovered parking space such as open parking areas. Now this is an important definition in the RERA, because in Mumbai prior to 84 we used to have garages, closed garages, and there were only hardly any Ambassador or Fiat were the cars available at that time. Maruti came very later on, somewhere after 75 or 77. Sorry. During this period in Mumbai, closed garages were permitted, and it was not inclusive or included in the total FSI available on the plot of land. So it was free of FSI, and you could see in the old buildings around constructed around 1975 to 77, closed garages were there. Either it is in the front or the rear side of the building, and people used to park the cars, but slowly gradually the car became bigger in the size and the garages were very small. So what happened, people started using it as a commercial place. They were using as a shop or office or a godown, and this became a menace, in the sense that it is over and above FSI they started using it. And after 1984 in Mumbai, closed garages were not permitted by the corporation, and they stopped giving permission for closed garages. Somewhere in 2010, there was a judgment of the Supreme Court in Lalchand Rathod, wherein it was said that builder cannot sell the car parking space, even stilt. Rightly so, because it was free of FSI and it was not concluded. So when a builder applies for the plan and he calculates the FSI, he has to pay the premium. So as far as the stilt is concerned, as it was free of FSI, he need not pay the premium. However, they were charging and selling the stilt. This gentleman went up to Supreme Court, and Supreme Court said that this is illegal and builder cannot charge. Subsequently, immediately thereafter, DC rule in Mumbai of 1991 was amended, and stilt parking or a parking space was included in the FSI, and builders started paying the price for it. So it became very legal for the builder to charge because they are paying the premium and construction cost is also there. There is a podium parking and stilt parking is also closed now. Virtually we see 3 level, 4 level, 7 level, sometimes it goes up to 10 level, level 10 parking. So they are charging and it is inclusive of FSI under 91 DCR. So the effect of that Lal Chand Rathod or the judgment of Lal Chand Rathod became nullity. We will stop here. Today's question is, I have received one question saying that whether any time limit is there or Limitation Act applies to the RERA. According to me, within a reasonable time, you can apply, but there is no application to RERA of Limitation Act. Limitation Act does not apply because sometimes for 15-20 years builders have not given possession or even the construction has not started despite of the fact that crores of rupees is collected from various flat purchasers. So there is no time limit or time frame for the flat purchasers, and they can have their redressal before the RERA authority despite that there is a delay of 10 years or 15 years. This is my analysis. There is no order of the RERA authority so far, but there may be a test case always, and we are waiting for that. I also said that we will analyze each and every state's RERA website. Today I will analyze my own state's website, which I really love it. It's very good. It is in Marathi and Hindi, not because just I belong to Maharashtra, but it is it's a good website. The only thing I don't get is the orders. When orders I want to search, let us see what it has. Home, about us. In about us there is an introduction, organization structure, facilities, leadership, media gallery and RTI. Downloads, we have Maharashtra, Daman and Diu, Dadra Nagar Haveli. So Maharashtra RERA's jurisdiction is Maharashtra, Daman and Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli. So in Maharashtra we have act, rules, GRs and circulars, regulations, orders and circulars of Maharera, rulings by Maharera, FAQ, suo motu orders by Maharera. Daman and Diu, we have acts, rules, circulars. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, acts, rules and circulars. Now let us go to order, rulings by Maharera. Sorry. In rulings by Maharera, I have an option, search rulings and judgments. Maharera complaint, Maharera non-compliance complaint. So Maharera complaint number I must have, which as a researcher naturally I don't have. Maharera project agent registration number, that also I don't have. Sometimes we get the name of the promoter, sometimes we don't have. We just read in the newspaper and trying to search from this website. Sometimes we get, but sometimes we have to spend a lot of time in searching it. Now there is an option of advanced search, in which ruling, judgment, date from. So that is available, but then it is random. Complainant name and respondent name, you can search the judgment. What I suggest is there has to be a separate page where we get all landmark judgments, because most of the judgments and the precedents are set by Maharera. So I request the authority to look into this for our convenience of the practitioners, to have all landmark judgments which has set the precedence, or the, no, it's an authority like Lavasa and letter of allotment. There are so many other rulings which are very important to know. So I request Maharashtra authority, RERA authority, to look into this and provide for us a separate page where we can search easily, free search, by newspaper items, whatever we gather we can put into the search engine and we get the entire detail of that judgment, it will be very helpful even for lawyers and the litigants. Contact, we have a contact information in this. Then registration, non-registration, inform, non-registration, we can inform. Non-registration application status, online application, appellate tribunal, cause list, orders and download. Here again I request to have orders in one page which are landmark. Conciliation form, here we have mediation in this RERA. We have a facility of mediation where a person doesn't want to litigate straight away. They can first go to a panel of mediators set out by the they have that panel of panelists. You can matter will be referred to mediation for settlement. If it is not settled, then again it will go back to RERA. So this is very good. There is list of conciliation procedure is laid down. Online application also you can do, and about the forum. Then there is a statistics given. How many applicant type, registration in Maharashtra, applications received and registration granted. Then Daman and Diu also same registration Maharera statistic is given. So basically this is a very good website. The only thing is we need the orders in one place whereby we can also have a search very easily. Sometimes we don't know the party's name even, because news item doesn't give, but they just give that allottees have won the matter, allotment letter is also can be scrutinized by RERA. So in such case we don't have more details. I request therefore that all landmark orders must be on the same page, so that with the name that this is what landmark judgment is, you know, it is laid down this, it is laid down. So a search engine can easily search it, and it will be very useful for us as a practitioner and the readers. Thank you very much. We will meet once again tomorrow. Till then, stay tuned. Goodbye.